going to the Lord. The Bible says that the Lord opens up the womb. Okay, and that he can bless. And we don't need to turn to any of our own devices to open up the womb. God is capable of doing everything. Even those who the world would call barren and have had problems, the Lord can open the womb. The Lord can open up the womb, and he does that. And I brought this point up in the past, you know, where we see Isaac praying for his wife to conceive, and it takes 20 years before the conception actually happens. Abraham and Sarah, they were childless Abraham was 100 years old, and Sarah was like 90 years old. So it can take a long time, no doubt about it, right? But God is capable of opening up the womb no matter what, right? He is able to do that, and we need to have the faith and trust in that. And that, oftentimes when you're praying, it may take longer than you would like for prayers to be answered. But we have to just trust in the Lord, that the Lord is good, and he'll hear our prayers. But let's continue on here, because that wasn't the focal point of the story at all. But let's keep reading verse number 22. It says, "And the children struggled together within her, and she said, 'If it be so, why am I thus?' And she went to inquire of the Lord." So the prayer's answered. She becomes pregnant. She conceives. And then it turns out that she's pregnant with twins. Now, it's interesting here because she's already starting to feel, this turmoil going on in the womb, right? So even from the womb, we're seeing that Jacob and Esau are butting heads. They're at odds with each other. They're brothers that are just always going to be fighting with each other. And the reason why it even, why would it bring up just her having problems within the womb? Because there's a greater teaching to that. And ultimately what you're going to see, and I'm going to make mention of this and point this out as we continue through this, is that the greater meaning we're going to be focusing on between Jacob and Esau, and when we read these stories about Jacob and Esau, is that by and large it's talking about nations and groups of people more than just the individuals. More than just the Jacob, the person, and the Esau, the person. When we learn about them and read about them, the characteristics and the traits and the things that are going on carry forward to two nations, not just to two individuals. And it's really important to understand that as we get into other passages and other scriptures, how that all makes sense then and applies appropriately as we see over and over again. And as I just said, look at verse number 23, the Bible says, "And the Lord said unto her," because she goes to inquire, why am I having all this problem in my womb? Like, it feels like, who knows what's going on, right? Why is that happening? And the Lord answers her prayer, answers her request, and said, "Two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be separated from thy bowels, and the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger." So this is the answer that the Lord gives, saying, it's because this goes, obviously, he says two nations and two manner of people, that goes way beyond just the individuals. So the teaching that's going on here, there's obviously something special going on with these children. There's something special going on with Rebecca, right? Giving birth to these nations of people. Jacob, and they did. They went on to become heads of great households in the sense that they had many descendants after them and had their own domain, their own land, and their own, nation, basically. Esau spawned off the Edomites. So when you read about Edom and the Edomites, that's all from Esau. We'll get to that a little bit later as well. And then Jacob becomes Israel, which, of course, are the Israelites, the nation of Israel coming from Jacob.